The people, the headlines, the issues impacting you. All on This Week in Cincinnati on 9 on Your Side.
Welcome back, everyone. This morning on This Week in Cincinnati, we are talking with Ohio Attorney General and candidate for governor, Mike DeWine, and we thank you again for joining us. I also want to mention we are joined by WCPO Opinion Director Dave Holthouse and 9 on Your Side reporter Tom McKee. I'm going to pass it off to you, Dave, to start. You know you have plenty of questions about heroin.
Yeah, thanks. General, the opioid crisis, as you know, is terrible in Ohio, and despite efforts by your office, the governor's office, local communities, law enforcement, it keeps getting worse. This week, Hamilton County Coroner said we've had a 31% increase in deaths in this county over last year. It seems like something more needs to be done. As governor, what would you do on the opioid crisis?
I would invite our viewers today to go up on my webpage. We have a 12-point action plan that I announced several months ago in regard to heroin. Let me just talk about a couple of those if I could. I think the most important thing that we can do, candidly, is the easiest to do, it's the cheapest to do, and it's what we're not doing. We're not doing enough with education. We're not doing enough with prevention. Every expert who I have talked to says if you're serious about this and really lowering the rate of addiction, not just opiates, but any kind of addiction, you got to start in kindergarten. You got to do something every single year. You got to do something that's age appropriate. You're not going to talk to kindergarten kids about heroin, but you might talk to them about not picking up that pill, about wellness, about health, and do that K through 12, age appropriate, but also make sure you're doing something every single year that has been proven to actually work. And so I put a group together along with the Speaker of the House, the Senate President several years ago. They came back with a report. And that report you can also find on our webpage. And basically what it is 20-some pages of here's how a school could start a program. Now, we have some schools that are doing K through 12 now. But most schools, quite candidly, are doing fifth grade. They might be doing ninth grade. And I'm not blaming the schools. Lord knows we expect the schools to do everything. But I don't know how we reach every kid in the state without doing it, frankly, through our schools, public, private, parochial, in charter. So I think that's the number one thing we're going to do. There will be someone in the office of the governor who will be directly accountable to me and will report directly to me in regard to the overall battle that we face.
Is there something we can do emergency basis to try to halt the death toll or turn it around at least? To keep the death toll from going up so much year from year.
Here's really what's happened, and I try to explain this to the national media because they're always calling and look at Ohio. Mm-hmm. And one of the things I point out is, look, we've been very open about our problem. I'm not sure that our problem is worse than Kentucky or West Virginia, some of our neighboring states, but it's bad. It's horrible. I mean, we're losing 15 people, we think, every single day. We're having babies born every day who are born addicted to drugs. Our foster care system is bursting at the seams with kids. Half of all the kids in foster care are there because one or both parents are drug addicts. I think, you know, we know some of the things that will in fact work. We have, on the law enforcement side, we have several task forces in the state that come under the Attorney General's office. Actually, I think we have four, moving into five. And they're what we call bulk cash task forces. And so they're aimed at not the street dealer, they're aimed at the Mexican drug cartel that's bringing these drugs in. And so what they do is they bring drugs in, we want to seize that we're seizing those drugs. What goes back out to Mexico is two things, money and guns. So we know those work. We need more of them to cover the entire state. That takes some money, but I think it's very, very important to do. Look, we also are seeing some things that work very, very well. Coleraine Township, for example, what we've seen is law enforcement becoming involved in getting people into treatment, something you never would have seen 10 years ago. But what we're seeing is a lot of good things at the local community area. The numbers would be down, but for the movement from the pain meds to the heroin, now to the fentanyl. And this fentanyl is a nasty, nasty stuff. It's 50 times, they tell me, 50 times more potent than heroin. They're now mixing it in to cocaine. They're mixing it in to everything. And so that's what's keeping the death rate, frankly, so high. But the good news is we got a lot going on at the local community, a lot of people doing some really heroic efforts at that local community.
I want to go ahead and bring in, if I can interrupt just for a moment, I want to bring in Tom McKee just real quickly because we have so much to get to in such a short space of time.
One of the biggest issues for Southwest Ohio certainly is the Brent Spence Bridge corridor, the idea of 4% of the gross domestic product of the country goes across that span every day. There's been efforts since 2002 at least to make a difference, to improve it. Nothing has been done. Would you support tolls to bring that project at least one step further to fruition?
Yeah, we have to build it. It has to be built. I've not seen any plan that would allow us to do this without tolls. I don't know how it can be built. Now, that may be not what people want to hear, but I think the business community, the leadership in Cincinnati understands that. Quite candidly, our problem has been Northern Kentucky. I'm not blaming Northern Kentucky. We love them, but there's been really political resistance to that. So my commitment to the people of Cincinnati and Southwest Ohio is while I'm governor, it's going to be a priority. I'll be talking directly to the governor of Kentucky, and we're going to, you know, make that a top priority, and we're going to focus on it because it has to be done.
Well, the Trump administration has made it clear 20% of federal funding would be for any type project. It would have to be local or state. Can the state help pay for this span?
Sure, the state can be, certainly the state's going to be involved. The state needs to be involved. But ultimately, you can't come up with that amount of money, without doing some sort of tolls. It's just not going to happen. And I hate to say that, but that's the truth.
Well, we're going
to build it. It's got to go. It's got to move forward.
We appreciate your candor on that issue. Absolutely. And we will wrap up our conversation with Ohio Attorney General Mike DeWine when we come back. So stay with us.